Welcome back to Let's Play Perihelion Blind for the Commodore Amiga. I am Amethyst Lunatari. It's so quiet. All we've got left are two enemies. They're two of the priests. We've got still got our normal guys bunched up over here, and Advent is messed up. Let me just go over what I got. We've been going up. Okay, so Killdozer is messed up. Advent can't heal him because he only has 33. It looks weird too. I thought he had just 3. Wait. 33, okay. Still not enough to cast Alpha Catharsis. We can cast beta spreadsheet, spreadsheet, select. What's selected now? Oh, beta spread point is selected. Oh, that's a glitch. It looks like there's some kind of artifact there. All right, let's get out of this then. See if we can cast. I was trying to look at people. So Killdozer's got 8. Epsilon's fine because he's hiding around the corner. The stamina has gone up. Look at that. Stamina's 118 now. Speed is 170 because I'm just having him go back and forth, up and down, side to side. And I guess that's increasing their stamina too. I'm not sure. His stamina's 114. The twin snake with the stamina 114, 108. These values have increased, I'm sure. Speed has increased, yeah, to 82. Speed here is 116. Awesome. And, so out of the two of them, I can heal one. How many? You know what I'm saying? These are all the bandages we have, too, so I just want to see something. Because he's been using them. 5 bandages left. Okay. Seemed like more than that. Alright, but no one needs to be bandaged, it's just that they're low. I think it would be best used on Killdozer, actually. Well, let's see if we can cast it. Well, it's not his turn. So it's really Killdozer and Advent are really not suited for going into battle right now. Twin Snake, not the best either, with just 51 stamina. They've been handling everything, these guys. They've been doing it all. And the others around the corner are almost unharmed. Almost. Alright, so who is turn now? Okay, so it's yours. Gus gonna defend then. I guess we're pulling these guys out. Just have them go here and defend. He was ready to hit somebody else. I'm gonna defend as well. Alright, so you wanna do this? Who is this? That is Advent. The spell was selected. Oh. What did I say it was? Alpha beta spread point. I want to look at it, just to make sure. Stamina and perception. Alright. Well, it says current collect selected. So it's telling me nothing selected, but then it's saying that's selected. Selected. Oh. You know, I think that's a glitch on the screen. I think he really... because he did have three. And I don't... that's a glitch. He really has three. Because I'm like, why would his... you know, his psi powers or whatever just go up 30 points randomly? Alright, so he can't do anything. What was this? You're defending. Because those sorcerers are not coming up here. Defend. Not sorcerers. I keep thinking of them in terms of magic. Defend. Actually, you should be mentally defending. Just thought of that. Oh, that's you. Okay. Defending. Who is this? Varanus. Trying to remember if he's a spellcasting character. I wish I could easily see all this stuff. Yeah. Alright. Wait. Life force drain. Let's try that. Oh, a blast. I think you need to get really up close and personal for that. We'll see. Nice. 10% perception. Where's his perception? Okay, 72. A spell ready for him. It's actually a damaging spell. Life force drain also. Because I can cast it a few times. A tunnel. Probably be better. Nice. Senses deadly, irresistibly penetrating astral energies. He senses it? Well, hopefully did more than sense it and go attack, damaged by it. Prepare another. Oh, what? He cast it on him. Ah. Oh, no, no. Varanus! Okay. Yeah, I have been using save states. This, you know, you make the slightest mistake. That's it. I'm back here before we kill this guy. Alright, I'll see you guys in a little bit when we get back to that area. I can't believe he casted on himself and killed himself. You know what threw me off, too? When you, go to, physically make a range attack on yourself, it won't let you. It says, hey, suicide's not an option. But yet, suicide through magic is an option. So I don't get it. Alright. Alright, back to it. This is not an area of spell, so please specify a definite target. I have to abort the current action and move forward one step. But he can cast us again. I guess this is the improvement of their speed. I thought we wouldn't see the effects until we rested, though. But, yeah, he's able to cast the spell again, and what's his name? Our lead character, what's it, Killdozer, he can attack twice in a round now as well. And he took the crossbow bolts from Advent and loaded into his crossbow, because I stopped having Advent attack because he was at 8 hit points. Attack. Nice! Two casts of that is enough to kill one of them. We have one left. I don't want anyone dying. Who is this? Okay. He's the one with 8 hit points, though. And here's the other one with 8 hit points. This is... Yeah, the only bad thing about Epsilon here is he can't get past anyone, so I'm just gonna have him defend. I'm just doing this to get their movement buff increase, whatever. Ah, unaffected. Can you believe that? Oh, not enough mental energy left. Alright, well then we're going to range attacks. Ah. That just kills me. Well, can we... We might be able to hit him from there. Oh, we can't reach. You can't reach, man! That's not what I wanted to do either. He still has... Does he still have points? He has 53. That should be fine. I think he couldn't reach, and that's why I boarded out. He can't reach. Oh, I didn't mean to do that again. This guy is doing this on purpose. Wait. We can't go further? I think he ended up getting closer in the end. That kills me every time at one square. Two. Just one square too short. Oh wait, we're doing a spell with this one. Unaffected. Oh boy, this last guy. Not enough mental energy, okay. Going to range attack. Works so well on the other one. Nice. Keep going. I'll teach you to mess around with us. Ha! It's like he doesn't know what to do. He's like, I'm getting out of here. No, I can't. I have to defeat the enemy. Wow. Advent. With speed. Twin Snake with stamina. Stamina. 125. My god. Stamina. And Advent was his speed, right? 55, I guess. Yeah, that's right. He always was a really slow guy. ...10% stamina. ...125. Wow. I guess this is how they become gods, like... ...and how they can take on a god. Because, it's gonna make things a lot easier with all these boosted stats. I think that's why it's the first battle is the hardest, because you're improved after this. Every time. Please specify a target. Your target. Yay! There's nobody else. The battle is over. The party has successfully defeated the enemy. Wow. Alright, it brings us back here for some reason. Alright, so I don't like him being at 8. I don't like him being an 8. Now, I've gone to save states a few times, which is normally a very bad thing to do. But maybe it's fine in a battle, because that's the way it was in Amber Moon. You couldn't use save states, but in battle you could. So, let's see if the game lets us save. We're on 9 now, aren't we? The game has been saved. Game is loaded, okay. It seems okay. Knocking on wood. Yeah, that took me forever to get through. Where are we now? We're facing south. I think we want to not face south. We were heading north? Let me look at my little map. Yeah, we need to head west. And then not that map. The movement. Yeah, west we need to go. Oh. There is no west. East? Oh, we're over here. Okay. This is... Ah! This is the one that was locked. The door seems to be secure with a rather sophisticated system. I thought we could go in there now. After all that. Wait. Did we pick anything up from anybody? Like, I don't remember anything said. Yeah, where's our loot? When do we get a chance to loot anything? The eastern quarter. Okay, so we're back. We're all the way back out here. Object and network detector. Is there something here? Alright, so I'm sensing something. It's either a network or an object. It's not an organism. And it's right here. Like, right ahead. Well, scan is for... Scan is for living organisms. Oh! Items on the ground, electronic key. You mean you literally have to look for this? Wow. This game is very unfriendly. How do I take it? Do I have it now? It's in the backpack. Okay. So if I go like this, I can analyze it. It's probably not going to say anything interesting. Electronic key. All classes, obviously. You guys are probably glad I'm playing this and not you. This is tough. Alright, so we have a key now for that place. So we're facing north at this point. It's just a dead end. We have to go south and around the corner here. Use the key. How do I use the key? Wait. Oh, this. Use selected item. You open the door mechanism successfully. Well, hooray. I'm gonna save now because that was a lot just to pick up a key. P9. I'm gonna blank here. This game is just killing my brain. Back to movement. Alright, save. This place looks undamaged. There's even a special network interface here. Interesting. Oh, good. That's right. I did my saves too, so we don't have to pay for the DIR. Oops. Logging in, and the little baby told us asylum. Connecting. Palace of Sunrise City. Asylum. List of files on asylum. We got emperor and permission. Pen. So I'm just careful about this, because I don't know if you can run out of money or how you get more money, or anything. As far as I know, at least in this first city, there's no vendors or anything like that. Alright, exit. Actually, well... I just want to get back to the, load game... option. Right. Oh, yes. Okay. Read. Emperor. Oh, pfft. Keep forgetting. I keep trying to parse it. Emperor. Oh, hello. That's what he looks like, huh? Hail, brothers. I'm Rex Helion, 34th Emperor of Perihelion. I must apologize for the method you had to use to find me. Gee, thanks. But you can... believe me, it was necessary. Our best mediators have discovered a special way of using very complicated cause and effect relations to mislead the unborn, because although it is getting more and more powerful, it is still half blind in our world. We have not much time left, so now I share with you all the information I've got. We were desperately searching for any similar situation in our history, and finally we found it in form of a small, incomplete file record in the Central Library of Cloudwing. The record tells that more than 30 years ago, a little sect has prevented the infiltration of a lesser entity into our dimension using a relic or device or something what they called the Guardian. We have checked the complete list of the sect members. Only one of them is still alive. Alright, I was gonna write this stuff down. We want a file record. I don't know if we could go here. I don't know if that's a place we can go. Central Library of Cloudwing. Cloudwing. It's a file record. The record. A lesser entity. So that stopped another one. What's with all these godlike entities coming into this place and trying to destroy everything? Tells of... I'm gonna put it in quotes on my little note here. The Guardian. Quote unquote. So, we need to talk to somebody in the Central Library of Cloudwing, either through the network or whatever. The name of that man is Mirak, but we have quite limited information about his current whereabouts. He had appeared last time in the Watchtower Colony, oh that's nearby, south of your present location. That man and his knowledge is possibly our very last hope. I'm afraid I won't be able to get in touch with you once again. It is already difficult to deal with the penetrating energy of the unborn, so download my special permission file. It will be my protective hand during your mission. What's the file name? Oh, it's the permission. So I'm not reading permission. I'm downloading permission. Okay. Talk to Mirak. I'll remember he's in Watchtower Colony. Okay. I think that's a bigger place. And remember, you're the most powerful strike force on the planet. If you fail, our world will be gone forever. Well, hey, no pressure or anything, you know. So what if I try to read permission? Oops. This is an exclusive Imperial permission, registration number, stuff. 010101 priority status, level 1 emergency state. Signed, His Divine Majesty Rex Helion the 34th. Alright, we have to download it. Which is costly, unfortunately. Current price is $650. Now it's $16.50, my god. Download complete. Exit. Oh. Log out. Then exit. Yeah, thanks. Just tell me about it. What's already there? Do we have it on our network now? Can I see it? We don't pay for a directory on our own network. Alright, so we have permit. I could have saved money by downloading it and then reading it. Because you can read it. Oh, I put a space after read. Doesn't like that. Beep boop boop boop. Yeah, you can read it now for free. Oh, we can read it now for free. Alright. I am gonna do it over, because reading stuff costs money. Let me just see. How much does that cost? When do we get to do an organism scan? Maybe that's in combat, like when we're standing next to somebody. I can't see wasting time doing that, though. The prices are here. DIR is 50, read is 100, so you could save another $100, or 100 credits, whatever. To download something is 1,000, just to log in is 200. But hey, free of taxes. Isn't it wonderful? Alright, so we're gonna do the following. This is what I recommend. Loading. Oops. DIR. Not DIR. I'm pretty sure we have to read it. We have to read this. Okay. Download. I don't know if I'm the only one that loves this. I don't love the prices, obviously, but I just love the whole part with, like, logging into this old-style, like, Unix frickin' network. It's awesome. For some reason, it really appeals to me. I kinda miss DOS. Yeah, $1,500 now for the price. Alright, so now we can get into our own network. Do a free directory. Our permission is there. We can read it. I don't know if it's necessary, but let's do it. Okay, I think we're set to leave, the name of this place again? Midlight. Been so long, feel like it. But we're learning things, we're learning the game. You can't see things on the ground, it's just you get alerts to objects. And then you have to go looking in your inventory and then see what's on the ground. That's something new I learned as well. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. Well, I guess we're going to Watchtower Colony. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.